San Monani, happy Sabbath again. And welcome to our visitors today. From all the way from Joburg, welcome. And Koko, you are also more than welcome. And my sister there that is visiting us for the first time. And to our regular members, you are very welcome today. Amen. Let us all close our eyes for a short word of prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace towards us. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you that you are with us today. We thank you for bringing us to another point of Sabbath, Lord, where we can come and fellowship with one another and learn of your great teacher. Learn the things that we forget, Lord. And we pray that you continue to bless us with your presence. Please continue to be with us, even now, as you have allowed me to come and share your word with your servants. Lord, we pray that your spirit may continue to be with us. And we pray that you please help us to take these things and put it into practice in our lives. I pray and I ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to continue. I will jump from Swati and English and try to mingle and put this together. Amen. The last time we did this subject of music, what did we say? We did the purpose of music. The last time we learned about the purpose of music. And we found out that music was purposed to do what?
Praise.
To praise, to glorify, to worship, to evangelize, to pray, to heal, to comfort, isn't it? It was purposed for holy use, isn't it? Umculo wadalelwa ukuze wenze izinto ezilungile nezinhle ukudumisa uNkulunkulu, isn't it? And that's what we learned the last time. Now, there's a question that we need to find out. As music was made for all the purposes, where was music created and in whom was it created? In whom? Amen. What? Umculo, thank you, Father Tessel. Umculo, wenziwa kuphi? And wayenzwa kubani? Ubani lo owayenzwa umculo ukuthi umculo ube wadalwa kubani? Angithi asiye encwadini Ezekiel. Ezekiel ukhona uphethe iSwati, iBhayibheli leSwati. iBhayibheli lesiSwati, we know in English is here, but I want the Swati to be read also. Umculo wadalwa kuphi and wadalwa kubani? Where was music created and in whom was it created? Ezekiel 28 verse 13. Let them do it in Swati first and then we can. It's in Swati. Mage Dube.
Verse 13.
Yes. Ezekiel 28 verse 13.
Wawuse again. Imbanzi sankulunkulu wawuhlotshiswe ngawo onke emanye laligugu ngemarubi nangematophasi nangema-emeralds nangema-chrysoprase nangema-onyx nangema-jaspi nangema-sapphire
nangema-emeralds
nangema-beryl. Kwekuhlanganisa ngamatshe akho nalugugu kwakwekunekwekuwanamathelisela kwekwentiwa negolide kwakwentiwa negolide kwalungiswa kahle konke loko nokulanga lowadalwa ngayo.
Nizwile ngithi. It says Sister Naomi, you can read. It says
that
was created in the garden of
God. Every precious stone was thy covering. The sardius, topaz, and the diamond, the beryl, the onyx, the jasper, the sapphire, the emerald, the carbuncle, and gold. The workmanship of thy tablets end of thy pipes was preparing thee in the day that thou was created.
So did you hear that? So this who does this verse speak about? Ngikhuluma ngabani ngo Lucifer le verse ngithi lithi yini e Lucifer was created where? At least we know he was in heaven, not here on earth. And then it says here, what was in him? Thy?
Everything.
And thy? Are these musical instruments?
Yes.
So those are musical instruments. So music was created here on earth.
No.
Where?
In
heaven. And in whom was it created?
Lucifer.
In Lucifer. And it. Next slide. Listen to this. It says here, music is a vital part of heaven and the throne of God. It has been part of what? Worship and praise of God since the beginning. Hang it. Lucifer was a beautiful and a wise archangel, an anointed cherub. And what music? Music was an integral part of his being. Umculo wadalwa kuLucifer. Umculo wadalwa kubani?
kuLucifer.
Next slide. God created Lucifer with supernatural abilities and talents in what?
Music.
In music, to be used daily for the glory of God. He set him in this position, which means he consecrated him. He set him aside, he consecrated him, isn't it? He ordained him and entrusted Lucifer as the what? The super ordained minister of what?
Music,
praise, and
worship.
Lucifer, wabeka umculo, wanikezwa uLucifer. Yonke uNkulunkulu wamthemba ukuthi azebe yini azoba umuntu okwazi ophatha umusic. Angithi sinama minister, we have got ministers of the word today, we know, right? So God trusted Lucifer also to be the minister of what? Of
music,
of
praise,
and of
worship.
Now listen to this one. It says here, tabrets, next slide. Tabrets and pipes, these are instruments. What are instruments as instruments?
In
Swati, I know.
Oh.
Igin. Do we call it igin? Yeah. Igin zazinga phakathi kuLucifer. Lucifer wadalwa ngigin. Siyakwazi siyavuma lokho ngithi. We agree. Lucifer was, he says, tabrets and pipes are musical instruments that were created in the very being of Lucifer. These percussions and wind instruments were part of him, just as what? Our
arms
and our
legs
and our
fingers
are part of what? Of us. Did you hear that? Let's put it today. All musical instruments you know, or musical instruments, were part of him as our fingers and our legs were part of him. Why is that? And it says here, he was a living instrument. Why is king Ahab? Lucifer. Why is king? And it says here, his music was glorious, he was the glorious perfection in every note, arrangement, pitch, beat, melody, and what?
Harmony.
Are all these elements of music?
Yes.
Are the elements? Is it as good as it? And it says here, everything was in perfection. All these elements was in perfection. So, Lucifer, why is wrong, brothers and sisters? So, hey, we're going to get somewhere. We're still understanding. We understood why music was created. So, we're understanding now, where is it, was it created? So that, can we say Lucifer was a skilled musician. We've got people that plays music, guitar, like, you know, and when you look at it, you say, yo, how does that guy do it? Even the piano, you say, how does that guy? Others have seen it, artists that plays it, they even do it, and they do it in other ways that you don't even know. And you're thinking, how does it guy even those who are blind, they play piano, and you're thinking, how do these people do it? And it, now, it says Lucifer was that instrument in him. So it was his very being, just like you have to sit and you have to eat and you have your hand and you, it was in him. So there's nothing you can do when it comes to music with him. Mm. Oh, you can't tell him anything.
When he speaks, music comes out. Mm.
It's gonna come there. That's why he says he was a living instrument. While his king appeared on it. Now the question says, what role was Lucifer what was his role concerning music? He ningxenye owayedlala uLucifer. Must figure out. Next slide. God firmly established Lucifer as a what?
Chief
musician and ordained him in this ministry of music. Music was a focal part of his occupation. Wayengumculo. This was his part. Into njengoba kayenza ukuthi wayengumntu womculo. He was we can say he was a choir leader. He was a leader. He was a musician. Next slide. He says, okay, go back for the lesson. There's something that I forgot to put there. He says, God firmly established Lucifer as a chief musician. That's what we just read now. Eh? Okay, I'm right. Okay, go back. Now, it says here, what music did Lucifer make? I mean, he was a music leader. He was a perfection. And he was an ordained minister. I mean, so what music did he make? Why is that umculo onjani?
Holy.
Why is that umculo onjani? Ongwe, angithi. Angithi sho siyavuma angithi. Okay, next slide. Let's read it. Ezekiel 28 verse 15 says, thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day thou wast created. What was created in Lucifer? Yini eyayidalwe Lucifer?
Music
instruments. So that means music that he was making was what?
Perfect
music. So he was, why is our music umculo njani? Oh, what's that thing?
Aye.
Opele. Opele. Langit. Okay, next slide.
Umasolegi.
The verse
says,
so umculo waye wenza umasolegi. The music was made, he was making was perfect. There was you could not find any fault in it. So let's see what is perfection. Perfect means what? Complete, helpful, wholesome, and sound. Did you hear it? Perfect means what?
Complete,
helpful, wholesome, and sound. Free from blemish and undefiled. It was perfect. It means to be perfectly in harmony and in what? Accord with what? With them. So was Lucifer umculo wayewenza wawuhlangene noqiniso? Wawuhambisana noqiniso? Yes, that's what he says here. He says his music was in perfect harmony with the truth. And he says here, this can be summed up by these words, speak and sound out what? Truth. Lucifer's music was perfect and complete. His music was like a healing balm throughout the halls of heaven. Umculo owayewenza wawuletha nani nenjabulo nokuphola enhlizweni. Angithi umculo Lucifer wayewenza ke lo. This was a music that Lucifer used to make. So now tell me, what happened as time went on? Yini eyenzakala isikhathi masihamba? Next slide. Next slide tells us, till iniquity was found in thee. So what music was Lucifer making? Perfect music. Until what? Iniquity was found in him. Wayeza umculo olungile, omsulwa, ohamba kahle, ogcwele, ophelele. Kwatholakala ini? Ububi ngaphakathi kubani? Kuyena. So if iniquity was found in him, so that means his music will never be perfect anymore. Because music was built in him. And yet, it was made up where? In him. So what iniquity? Ibubi lo bubi. Ibubi lo bubi. Next slide. In Swati, what does it say? Ask Peggy, what does it say in Swati? Isaiah 14, verse 13 and 14. Yibuphi lo bubi lo? Isaiah 13, I mean 14, verse 13 and 14. Before we read it in Swati, it's in Swati. Okay, let me try. It's just that I don't want to waste time, but I can try. My sister Simpiwe is not here today too.
Ukhulume enhlitweni yakho. Ukhulume enhlitweni yakho wathi ngiyakunyukela etulu ezulwini. Ngiyawuphakamisa sihlalo sami sebukhosi sibe ngetulu kweti nkanyeti kankulunkulu. Ngiyawuhlala esihlalweni sebukhosi etikwetinhlaba yenhlanganiso yabonkulunkulu esicongweni senzaba lengcwele.
Okay. In fact, in English, what does it say? Please read it. Naomi, thou shalt.
Thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. Mm-hmm. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. Mm-hmm. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High.
Hmm. Did you hear that? So, in iniquity was found in him. Why is Kukumeza the man? Lucifer was exalting himself. He says, I will be like the Most High. I will sit above the congregation of the stars. I will be like the what? The Most High. So what did he desire? Worship. What was music made for? To do what? Worship, praise, elevate, encourage, heal. That's what it was made for. So since Lucifer was found in with iniquity and was making good music that was focusing and bringing honor and worship to God, what kind of music was he making now after he fell? Ngicabanga ukuthi umculo wayo wenza bese umculo onjani manje? Umnyama. What did you say, Jamal?
Amapiano.
Yeah, you can say that. That kind of music he was making. Why says umculo omnyama? Next slide. Listen to this now. He says, the hour, listen, tell me where. Since Lucifer was found not right anymore, what happened to him?
He got kicked
out and it. He says here, the hour of joyful, happy songs of praise to God and his dear son had what? Had come. Satan, who was what? Lucifer. Immediately when he fell, he became what? Satan. Had led the heavenly choir, isn't it? He was a choir leader, isn't it? He was making what music? Perfect music. Music that did what? Brought glory and worship to who? To God. Why is it or later?
Indumiso
kunkulunkulu nobali nendodana yakhe. Thank you. Akim. His God and who? And his son. Listen to this. He had raised the first note. Then all the angelic host had united with him. And glorious strains of music had resounded through heaven. In the honor of who? And his?
Yes, sir.
So, Lucifer would sing first and bring glory to God as a leader. And then wonke ama angelusi bese ziyacula now. And then to bring honor and glory to who? To God and who? And his son. Next slide. Now listen to this. But now, instead of strains of sweet music, discord and angry words fell upon the ear of the great rebel leader. Where is he? Is it not all a horrible dream? Is he shut out of heaven? Are the gates of heaven never more to open to admit him? The hour of what?
Worship.
The hour of worship draws nigh. When bright and holy angels bow before their Father, no more will he unite in heavenly song. No more will he bow in reverence and holy awe before the presence of the eternal God. So he could not even do what he had to do. But listen to this. He Did Lucifer know that music must bring honor and glory and worship to God and his son?
Yes.
Did it eat him that he can't do that anymore?
Yes.
Even though there was evil in him, but he knew that this is his being. It was his nature to do that. But it did touch him. It did touch him when you look at this. Because now, but what kind of music now was playing in his mind inside? Angry and discord. Music without head, what? Discord and angry. Wait. This is scary, brothers and sisters. Yes, Brother Preston, what do you want to say?
No, I'm just thinking also with the time Christ was on earth, he sent his disciples to get, like a donkey or something?
Yes.
He clothed it and then bring it to him.
Yeah.
That he may travel on it and then know that the king has arrived.
Yeah.
Now it says in Luke 19, I'll read from verse 37.
Yes.
It says there, and when he had come nigh, even now, at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen.
Amen.
Then it says, saying, blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven and glory in the highest.
Amen.
Now listen, it says, and some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said to him, Master, rebuke thy disciples. Listen to verse 14.
Yes.
And he answered and said unto them, I tell you that if these should hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out.
Yeah. Amen.
So even nature knows its duty.
It has to sing back to the Lord.
Worship. That everything goes straight and back to the Father.
Amen. Amen. Did you hear that? So even then, nature knows that it is praise and worship and song and music must if it was made for God's glory. Now listen to this. This is what happened to Lucifer. He was cast out. It says here, now, since music, it says here, since the enemy was cast out out of heaven and he was cast unto the earth, was his talent stripped from him?
No.
His ability to make music?
No.
It was still in him, ain't it? Tell me now. Who, listen to this. Who, what did he do? It says here, the devil, he was cast out, and Satan, which does what?
Deceiveth
the who? The whole world. He was cast out. And his who? Angels were cast out with him. So, when he was cast out, who did he try his ability to deceive here on earth? Who did he use first?
Adam
and Eve. In fact, Eve, isn't it? That you don't have to read it. That is in Genesis 1. Genesis 3, verse 1. Let's just read this one verse. Genesis 3, let's go there. And verse 1. We're looking at the apostasy of music. Sibheka ukuthi umculo usuke la ebungcweleni wawa kanjani. And uze wafika kanjani la ukhona. Genesis 3 verse 1, I'm going to read it and I want you to read it in Swati. Okay, read it in Swati. Genesis 3 verse 1. This one, thank you. It says, now the serpent was more subtle. Do you know what subtle means? It was more cunning, it was kind, it was fine, it was clever, that's subtle. It was very sneaky, we can say. And it says it was fine, it was clever, do you understand? It was, yes, than any other beast. It was beautiful, it was fine, it was clever. Now, we say Satan used the serpent as a medium. He used it as a what? As a medium to deceive who? Eve. And it. He used it as a medium, isn't it? And then Eve was deceived, and it. Let's find out how did he do it. Can you read it? The angels?
The angels had cautioned Eve to beware of separating herself from her husband while occupied in their daily labor in the garden. With him, she would be in less danger from temptation than if she were alone. But absorbed in her pleasing task, she unconsciously wandered from his side. And on perceiving that she was alone, she felt an apprehension of danger, but dismissed her fears, deciding that she had sufficient wisdom and strength to discern evil and to withstand it. Unmindful of the angel's caution, she soon found herself gazing with mingled curiosity and admiration upon the forbidden tree.
Ithi lana u-Eve watshelwa ingelosi ukuthi ungahambi uhlukane nomkakho ngoba monga bamtshelile ukuthi ukhona ubani uSathane uzoza azonilahlekisa manje ukuze angangitholi kumele nihlale ninonke ningahlukani angithi next slide bamtshela wayazi u-Eve next slide.
The fruit was very beautiful, and she questioned with herself why God had withheld it from them. Now was the tempter's opportunity. As if he were able to discern the workings of her mind, he addressed her.
Stop right there. And among coming on the market, who started what had a chance to get up? Nibonin, Nizwin. Okay, next slide.
Yea, hath God said he shall not eat of every tree of the garden? Eve was surprised and startled as she thus seemed to hear the echo of her thoughts.
Listen, Eve, inyoka niyakhuluma uyive wacabanga ukuthi hawu naye le ngqondo into engiyicabanga naye ngiyayizwa kulo muntu neza. Please remember this very very carefully. We're gonna see what it does, what music does. Okay, continue. Part there.
But the serpent continued in a musical voice.
Okay, stop right there.
Sure.
Can you understand ukuthi why did Eve why she couldn't resist? Niyathola ukuthi why u-Eve angakwazanga ukuze akwazi ukuresista. Why?
Yeah,
it is because Satan continued in what voice?
Musical voice.
Sure. This is deep. This is very deep. He didn't just speak. He spoke in what name? Musical voice. Music was meant in him. Brothers and sisters, be careful. Umculo esimamelayo. Yes, Father.
And it's something that they were accustomed to because they knew how to praise God and everything. So it came with something that seemed right to them because it was something that they knew.
Thank you. This is the whole study we're doing. It's going to come to that point where we see what happens even to the music where people say, it's just an instrument. There's no lyrics. Oh, let me take instrument and put lyrics in. You still want to see. It might seem right, but the whole, it says, Satan deceived the whole world. And that's what's happening. He says that he continued with the what? Musical voice. With subtle. Did you see subtle there in the Genesis book?
Yes.
He says with what? Subtle what? Praise. Not to God, but to who? To her. Don't we do that? Don't we do that and take the glory that belongs to God and we take it away now and bring it. How many R&B songs are sang to people? Those people are taking the place of God. Even the writers that are doing, it's the same thing. This, it was musical voice was subtle and praise of what? Of her. Her surpassing of what? Her loveliness. She couldn't resist when she hears this in a song, how lovely she is. And his words were not displeasing. So the words were welcomed by Eve.
She loved it.
Into the guy issue Satan, we turned into Eve. That's what we do with music, am I right? I'm talking to the young ones now. Young ones, when we listen to music, it says that it's like that guy who wrote that knows what we're feeling. We say that, isn't it? That's what we say. He knows exactly what I feel and where I am. That's what they say. Instead of doing what?
Fleeing.
Instead of fleeing from the spot, she lingered wondering to hear the serpent speak. So how many times does Satan speak to us and we linger, we take long to run away? Even when we hear music, any other, we linger, we take long instead of running away. Umculo. We linger, we take long. And let me tell you, if you are in a place where good music is not played, you are going to start doing the things that that music suggests. Or that music is categorized into. You are going to do it. That is a fact. It doesn't change. This thing has power. This.
Hypnotizes.
Due to time, I don't think we're going to do everything. We're going to continue. In fact, you know what? Can I stop it right here? Can I just leave it here? Because I only have 2 minutes. And then we can just speak about it. I don't want to...
Not prolong.
I don't want to... Because we can only, just by this, we can take a lot. We can speak a lot about it. Did you want to say something quickly?
Yes. What I wanted to say is... You can even look at it, and some people say, yeah, but I know how my relationship is with God. Music doesn't affect me, but it's not to
That's what
because
you're saying.
You can take the most sincere child that has been removed from any source of worldly atmosphere and take him to the mall, and there's drums playing, you will see his body start to move. Because Satan knows the anatomy, and he studied it and he's worked that into his music to attract people.
He was a minister. Look, he was ordained to be the minister of music. The Sabbath was consecrated and it was set aside, isn't it? It was ordained, isn't it? Just like him, he was ordained, he was an archangel. He was for music. Music was for him. He is music. When you hear music, God gave it to him and said, you are the worship leader, you are music, because you bring glory to me. We, like you're saying, it is here, so we're going to leave it for the next time. All of those things, even the Satan, he knows what he's doing. Yes, Sister Kenzie, what did you say?
I was just going to say, music rapes you. It takes control of you without your permission.
Yes.
It plays in you. Yeah. And the only thing that can rescue from that music that has played in you is good and holy music.
Thank you. You are so right.
There's nothing else that can deliver you from that music.
Yes,
That's how powerful it is.
In fact, I don't want to continue from here, because I only have 30 seconds. I'm just going to leave it. Anyone wants to say anything? No. Yes, Father Preston.
No, I wanted to say actually what Brother Andrew Kenos was saying now. You know, Pen of Inspiration says that your conscience is the Holy Spirit speaking to you.
Yes.
So if you... like the worldly people, they studied this to tell us that music is the only thing that can surpass your conscience without your permission. So imagine now it surpasses, and we now know the spirit of prophecy says that our conscience is the Holy Spirit speaking to us.
Yes.
If that passes that, you must keep in mind, Pen of Inspiration says that Satan fears the third being of the Godhead. If he surpasses that, then what other defense mode can you actually have?
Exactly.
Because now, once it passes your defense mode, then he has full control over it. That's why today, or even back in the day, they would listen to horrible music and then go and kill each other.
Exactly. You even
know?
Now.
Because of the music. Even now, I mean, rock and roll people, you can see how evil they look. But how much people are dedicated just to that people? You can see it's evil.
Yes,
they scratch themselves, it's makeup. They tell you straight, we worship the devil.
Yes.
But they tell you straight, and we also by world, because of the music, we go and we worship them.
Brothers and sisters, this purpose of this study is, as we know, the enemy, Satan and Lucifer, is music. And music was purposed for holy and to bring us closer to God. Why are we in as Seventh-day Adventists still play, even in the church and in homes, in our phones everywhere, we still play things that are not, we know that are not right. Just one statement, it's here, but I'm not going to talk about it. It says, your subconscious is being bewitched by music and you don't even know it. It's here. We're going to read it about it. And what kind of music is it speak about? It speak about music that is not attached to God, that God didn't breathe a Holy Spirit upon. Sometimes we call it Christian music, but it has nothing to do with God. We play it, and then it lasts longer. That's what it says. Yes, Lord. Is there anyone that wants to say anything before we pray? So we understand, where was music created?
In heaven.
And in who was it recreated?
In Lucifer.
And what was it created for? Worship, praise, to give glory to God. What music was he making while he was still in perfect order with God?
Perfect.
A perfect music. So since he fell down, what music was he making now? Imperfect music. And that's what he's doing now. We must understand. He has to use, he used this for the good. Now he's using this for the bad. Amen. Oh yes, my sister.
I also wanted to comment. There's this other girl on YouTube, and she's also on Facebook.
Yes.
Ish, I forget her name, but she's not Adventist, but she speaks a lot about these things. She loves, because she's still very young, so she will make example even with the pianos. You know, the amapiano is what's mostly common now amongst the young people. And she will make us listen to a small portion of the music, and she'll hear, do you hear that? Do you hear the chants? So you even hear the chanting. So every time you sing, there's even be like amapapa for no reason in the song, and she will tell you it sounds horrible. And then she'll ask me, but what is so? There's no words in the song. But people love it so much. It's just those chants and chants.
You get those things.
All of those things.
Yeah.
And she would explain that this is a form of worship to the devil. Even they
we
use
know.
These things to worship the devil. It's scary.
Scary, brothers and sisters. Yeah.
It excites people. So when it excites people, it automatically praises him.
Yeah.
Because it's all about him. So
remember,
he sits on his throne just smiling while everybody's enjoying his music.
Exactly.
And yet God should be praised.
Amen.
What music?
Yes, amen. Can we pray? Oh, did you want to hear
something? I was just thinking as you speak about this, that I have a friend that he was with his girlfriend, and then he played music, but with loud drums, and the girlfriend got up and she said, what is this that you play? And then he said, I am praying. What you mean now? I'm praying now. And it was loud drums, and then she said, oh, and then she went in. And when he was explaining to me, I'm thinking, oh, you can already imagine, as he's telling me, I'm praying, and he said loud drums. It's always to, what do we call
excite.
It? Yeah, it must excite you. It's
yes.
not to humble you.
No,
you. It must always make you feel like you can jump through the roof.
Yeah, it's like adrenaline, to give you adrenaline, yes. Yes, Father Jose.
I just wanted to say, Satan came to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yes.
And that's his purpose. And he knows that, I can't remember who says earlier, but he knows the anatomy of a human being.
Yeah.
We are over 70% or 80% water.
Yeah.
And our brains even more.
Yes.
And there's even a study being done on how music can affect water.
Exactly.
So Satan basically knows that the only way that God can communicate with us is through our brains.
Exactly.
And that's why he's trying to destroy. That's why he needs something that's going to bypass the brain, and that is music.
Exactly. He knows. That's what this is, what the whole study is telling us about. Thank you, my brother. So we get to the point of why we're making these new studies, so that we can be vigilant. As we say, we are preparing to go to heaven. We need to reform in all aspects of our lives. Amen.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Let us all go on our knees as we're going to be taking a short break. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace towards us and your mercy. We thank you that you have taught us and showed us the things that we need to learn. Please open our hearts and our minds so that we do not hold back and we do not and grieve the Spirit of God that is constantly speaking to us. Even now, as we're going to take a break, may you please help us to remember that we are still in the presence of God. I pray and I ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord, I care not for riches, neither silver nor gold. I would make sure of heaven, I would enter the fold. In the book of thy kingdom, with its pages so fair, tell me, Jesus, my Savior. Is my name written there?